Hello, my name's Don McFarlane. I'm the team leader of a group of animals called ectotherms here at Auckland Zoo. That includes around 50 species of reptile, amphibian, fish and invertebrates. The animals that we work with here are incredibly rare, and we've had the great privilege of not only working with them, but of course putting them back to the wild where they belong. So as a keeper, you shouldn't really have favourites, but I must admit to having a few of my own, and they include the wetapunga, the famous wetapunga.
Here she is. So a lot of people don't realise that some of our weta are actually very endangered. So this one's a threatened species because the entire population is only found on one island and has been for the last 100 years. Here at the zoo, we're involved in a project to breed the species up and restore them back to other islands in the Hauraki Gulf.
Another top five for me has to be the long-finned eel, which are native to New Zealand, and of course they get to whopping sizes, something like 2 meters and 40 kilos. What really impresses me about this eel is the journey it makes. We know it swims many, many thousands of kilometers from New Zealand shores off to the depths of Tonga, where they lay their many millions of eggs, and somehow the young find their way all the way back to start the life again. Tuatara are odd in so many ways, it's difficult to count. Certainly they live at temperatures which few other reptiles can tolerate. New Zealand is very cold in parts, but that hasn't deterred the tuatara. Another bizarre fact about the tuatara is that they have light-sensitive cells in the centre of their head that act much like a third eye. Green geckos, what do I love about them? I think their colour is ridiculous. They look like they've been fluorescent painted for a start. Some of them have jet black mouths as a threat display when they open their mouths. Some species of the geckos in New Zealand are famous also for being able to lick their own eyeballs. They're unable to blink, so they have a slightly extended tongue to do that job. The other cool fact about green geckos that I like is their tail. It's called prehensile because it's able to grip independently, almost like a fifth limb. It's extremely handy when you live up in the trees. The Archie's frog is my favourite New Zealand native animal. It's difficult to know where to begin, why it deserves that position. I think for me it's because it's utterly unique. They are essentially like a piece of moss to look at. They blend in so perfectly to their fairy-like environment. Really, really dark valleys where it's very cold and covered in moss.
This is the darkened room that is behind our Archie's frog exhibit. So it's dark in here and it's refrigerated to keep it cool like it is up in the cloud forests of Fireno and Coromandel where the frogs come from. And we also hold down here in this darkened and cooled room some very exciting eggs that we've got this year. There are the eggs and you can see the tadpoles just moving around inside the eggs.
When I started to learn a little bit more about the animals that I look after now, I realised that tragically a lot of them are in serious need of some help. They're on the edge of extinction, and I chose to devote my life to doing what I can to help them back to a population that they once were. So if you really want to help the great unsung ectotherms of New Zealand, well, come and visit us here at Auckland Zoo and see them in the flesh.